Hi, this is Alicia of One Blushing Bride. I am a wedding veil designer. How much should your wedding veil cost? When you go into the salon, they put you in a few different options and it costs maybe a couple thousand dollars. Then you look on Amazon and eBay and you see some options that are literally $20. So what are your options? Are you being ripped off at the salon? Are you paying too much? If you go with a less expensive option, is it just going to end up looking cheap? Well, I'm going to answer all of those questions, and by the time you listen to this, you will understand what factors impact the price of your wedding veil and some clever ways that you can stay within budget while still looking elegant. Make sure to stay tuned till the end, where I will cover how you can grab your free veil style guide and your free samples. That's a win. So the average wedding veil costs between $200 and $400 these days. That is what most brides pay. Of course, that can vary depending on what it is you are asking for. So some of the factors that go into a wedding veil would be the quality of the materials that are used. That's the first factor. The second factor would be, what sort of customizations are you asking for? Are you asking for a lot of different small touches to be made, or are you just buying it off the rack and it's already ready to wear, ready to buy? And the third factor would be basically, what are the overhead costs of the salon that you're purchasing from? Are you purchasing from a really nice, expensive location, or are you purchasing from maybe a home business, a home studio? Because that's going to all factor into the price of your wedding veil. Let's talk about the quality of the materials of the veil. Now, this should be pretty evident to most people, just feeling a veil. Some of them will be more scratchy, whereas some of them will be softer against your skin. And almost all veils that are quality veils will be made from something called bridal illusion tulle. You want something that's bridal illusion tulle rather than regular tulle, because tulle is something that you would picture in a little girl's tutu, like a ballerina, you know, the type that sticks out really straight and that is kind of coarse. But you're going to want something that is made from bridal illusion tulle because it's softer against your skin, and the last thing you want is to be uncomfortable on your wedding day. The other option for brides, if you want something a little bit nicer, is something called English net. English net is one of my personal favorite fabrics. It drapes really softly. It's a little bit heavier, so I'll show some photos and you can see. But basically, this fabric allows a smoother drape, and it's a little bit less opaque as compared to regular tulle. So that's a little bit more pricey. And then of course the most expensive fabric is regular silk, which I don't recommend for a lot of you because silk can be very expensive. And the royals wear it, but you have to be super careful with it because it snags really easy. So those silk veils will definitely be thousands of dollars. So if that's not in your price range, I would recommend sticking with bridal illusion tulle, but a nice quality bridal illusion tulle. And you can actually request free samples from a lot of designers. Make sure that you know their return policy before ordering if you're not able to see those samples. But most quality designers will send you samples so that you can feel it in person and see if you're gonna like how it feels against your skin. That's very important. The second factor that goes into determining the cost of your veil is the amount of customizations that you are requesting. So are you having a piece that is hand designed just for you, or are you buying something that is off the rack, ready to go, and it's shipped that same day? Something that is customized for you, and say you're wanting a lot of things added on, you want the lace, you want the crystals, you want the, maybe you even want flowers and embroidery, maybe you want a monogram. If you're adding on all those things, the price is going to go up. So just keep your budget in mind and be real about what your budget is ahead of time, and you might have to adjust your expectations a little bit. And I found that the more honest you are with designers about what your true budget is, the better chance they have of designing something that's really special for you.
Now, the last main difference in the prices of veils generally has to do with where you are purchasing from. Are you purchasing from a posh bridal store or from a designer working from their studio or from their home? If you purchased your bridal veil from a fancy salon, maybe they have some crystal chandeliers, an ornate raised walkway, maybe they even have champagne served in crystal flutes, but perhaps your wedding veil will be a bit more expensive if you order from this salon. The salon owners have to cover the cost of keeping their luxurious salon going, and so the prices of the veils will be a bit higher. You will pay more for that lovely experience. On the other hand, if you are purchasing online from a designer who works from home
or who works from their studio or from a less ritzy bridal salon, then you can trust that the prices will be more affordable. After all, they're not having to pay for the fancy champagne and the bridal consultants. Now, I promised you a free must-have resource for elegant brides, and I have not forgotten. Make sure to check out the link in the description below for the Ultimate Wedding Veil Style Guide. This is for you if you're wanting to feel beautiful and confident walking down the aisle, and you want to do it without driving to a million salons and possibly having a couple of bridal breakdowns before making a decision. Just imagine how beautiful you'll feel in your elegant, timeless wedding day look that your friends will envy. Dreamy, right? Thanks for tuning in.